Well, I'm glad he could join us. Jeff Long is with us right now. He's an artist and specializes in birds, and we're going to find out more about that and why in just a couple of minutes, and where his work can be seen. Nice to see you, Jeff.
Good to see you, Jack.
Okay, do you work from live? Do you go out to the zoo or do you go out in the woods?
I do.
How do you do that?
Well, I'm doing a series called Birds of California, and I'm continuing the project that Audubon started in the 19th century, his Birds of America. But
right.
Audubon never traveled to the West. He never got past the Great Plains. So I'm providing the record of the Western birds in the context of their habitats, which Audubon never had the opportunity to do.
Let me ask you about Audubon, because that's interesting, the fact that he is the number one. When you think of this kind of work, you think of Audubon.
That's right.
Okay. What about the other artists of that era?
Well, there were others. There were those.
What happened to them? Did he have a good publicist?
Well, there are those who preceded Audubon, but they usually had a more stiff approach. Audubon was the first to introduce realism in a sense posing the birds, his dead specimens, in realistic, lifelike ways.
Yeah,
and he was a very skilled guy.
He didn't bring in a live bird and say, hold that pose.
Right. No, on the contrary, he shot them and then he set them up.
Yeah.
But anyway, what I'm doing is, on a very large format, taking and doing a postmodern take on Audubon, in that I'm showing the impacts of history and the environmental changes that have taken place on this continent and how they have affected these species. So there is an environmental edge to all of these pictures.
Are we talking about DDT and the use of DDT?
That habitat destruction and urbanization and all of that as well. And each bird painting that I'm doing has a backstory in that way. It has a narrative. So in that sense, they're sort of beyond Audubon's venue, beyond his purview, rather. Not something he would have dreamt of.
Yeah.
So I'm showing these now in San Francisco at Toomey Terrell Gallery at 49 Geary down near Union Square. I'm also showing them at the Transamerica Center. And I'm in a group show at the David Brower Center in Berkeley. And all of these shows are to benefit Earth Island Institute, which was founded by that legendary environmentalist David Brower, who was head of the Sierra Club before he founded Earth Island.
Yeah.
And Earth Island does great environmental work around the world. They are like a seed bed for the Rainforest Action Network and many other groups all over the world, and they do great work. So, for that reason, I've chosen them to benefit from these shows.
Well, the bird population around the world, in addition to the animal population around the world, has been, as long as there's been an Earth, has been going through a transition. Generation after generation of animals and birds have changed throughout through the millions of years. And to be able to record some of that and bring it up to contemporary times, as the paintings that you do, for example.
The iconic bird of California, one of the iconic birds, is an endemic species, meaning it's only in California.
Right.
And it's a very flashy, large, black and white bird called the yellow-billed magpie of the Central Valley. That painting of that bird, I've got the two birds in flight above a stockyard. In other words, thousands of cattle down below them. And it's showing sort of the environmental effects of industrial agriculture in the Central Valley at the same time, and how that has shaped the environment for these birds.
Jeff, nice having you here. Jeff Long has been our guest. He's an artist doing the Birds of California. Thank you very much for joining us.
Thank you, Jeff.